And up skating out first. Hello, welcome back, by the way. Sorry, we're kind of jumping into the deep end there, but we've got Leeds Roll It All skating out. We've got number 45, Livid Doll. She's the captain. 209 is Sheer Carnage, vice-captain. Number 0 is Feral Fairy.
And up skating out first. Hello,
number
welcome
6
back, by the way. Sorry, we're kind of jumping into the deep
Killer Roo.
We've got Leeds Roll It All skating out. We've got number 45, Livid Dolls, is the captain.
And we've got number 16, Tripping the Velvet. Number 69, Immodesty Grays. 72 HR is Rigor Mortis. Well, I think her name might be Rigor Morris. Is that a typo? Quite possibly. Number 88, we've got Nina. 777 is Sally Jones. 800 is Ms. Trixie. And VO5 is Rapunzel. That's Leeds Roller Dolls with their bench and lineup as put to hello. And Magic 8 Brawl. So sorry about the rushing there, but we just managed to come live again just at the very moment that Leeds were doing their skate out. Next to take the track, we've got the Newcastle Roller Girls Canny Belters. We've got the captain, 1P Penny Bazaar. The co-captain, sorry, we've got the co-captain, 5LY is Sly. Triple Zero, D-Rama Bomb. Number 11, Gin and Sonic. Number 18, Big Tall Jock. Number 52, Books Liz. Number 75 is Guinevere of Jamalot. Number 79 is Spangled. Number 206 is Elemental. Number C2C is Hit One, Pearl One. Number 14J is Missy Popo. We've got MC2 is Eek. We've got YI3, Anita Be Nasty. And we've got the bench and lineup as Dark Matter and Miss Wyatt. And that is the Canny Belters for Newcastle Roller Girls. So with both teams having completed their skateouts now and smiles all around, the game should be good to kick off shortly, so yeah, apologies for the slight delay. I think we're about 12 minutes behind schedule. But as we have dispensed with the official kit checks now, as each skater is responsible for their own kit, we should be good to go. It looks like we are having a kit check after all. It's obviously safer to do so, make sure everybody's wearing regulation kit, because you know it is a full contact sport and you don't want to leave something unprotected that could have been avoided and suffer an injury essentially, or cause somebody else an injury. So a brief kit check there from the refs, and the Canny Belters are the first to take the track. Looks like Penny Bazaar is going to be the first to jam, with Sally Jones jamming for Leeds. The Canny Belters taking the back line, leaving the front for Leeds. And we're underway. Sally Jones is pushing on the inside, but she's pushed to the outside. The lane four is blocked by Missy Power Powers. Penny is knocked to the floor by Riggs, but a penalty is called, and Penny is through on the inside. So that's lead jammer. The first lead jammer goes to the Canny Belters. And Penny Jones just about to lap Jones as she comes through on a scoring pass. She's knocked to the inside of the outside. She's knocked off by, was that 800, Miss Trixie. So she recycles back behind her. But meanwhile, Sally Jones is being recycled constantly by the four wall of the Canny Belters. But she manages to break through the middle. So Sally Jones is she passed? Yes, she just pushes past the shoulder of Ellie Mantle. Manages to skip through the inside of Hit One Pearl One. And she's through for a scoring pass as Penny fights to get through on the inside. She passes all but one, was that? How many points are being held? Oh, that's 5 points. 5 points for Newcastle. No points to lead. So that's a well-timed call-off by Penny as she gets all 5 points and denies Leeds any points. So after the first jam, it's 5-0 to Newcastle, and Leeds have a blocker in the bin. So a 4-3 pack advantage to the Canny Belters going into the second jam with Sly jamming for the Canny Belters. And I can't quite see the jammer, but as soon as I can, I'll tell you who it is. If you can see, you know. And a little fake to the inside there from Sly. She pushes on the outside. She pushes in lane three.
Or it's Rapunzel jamming for Lee. She's knocked to the outside, but the inside is left open. The blocker's in the way. But Anita Benasti is the last line of defence. Does she get Rapunzel off? She does, and she tries to recycle her, but she manages to get through as lead. Back on track before the cut could actually happen. Meanwhile, some interference is being run, and Sly is now through for a scoring pass, but she's nearly a half lap behind. As Rapunzel comes through, oh, a little shoulder from Liz, books Liz. She manages to knock around it. It's not effective. She gets the points and calls the jam. So that's 4 points to Leeds and 0 to Newcastle. So yeah, 5-4 after two jams. Now we've got Gwynethir of Gemmalot jamming for Leeds, and sorry, for Newcastle. And again, the Leeds jammer is hiding from me. But it looks like, well, it sounds like indeed, like it's going to be Nina, number 88 for Leeds. So the bin is empty, so we've got 4-on-4 as Gwynethir's pushing against that wall. She's pushing from the middle to the inside, while Nina is fighting against the back block, the booty blocks of Hit One Pill One and D-Rama Bomb. So that it's a congested pack. You can see the arms of Ellie Menzel come up to prove that she's not doing any illegal blocking at all, but Nina skips around on the outside. Nina is through for lead for Leeds. Lead for Leeds, but just as she comes through to a scoring pass, Gwynethir breaks the pack. She's through for a scoring pass, but Missy Pow Pow looks like she knocked her off to recycle her, so that's 2 points to Leeds and 0 to Newcastle. So that's a lead change for Leeds, only by a point, but every point counts. So it's 6-5 to Leeds going into jam 4, and it's the first jam for Big Tall Jock with number 0 Feral Fairy starting way back behind the jammer line. This could be to avoid any jammer action, or it could be to get a lovely little bit of speed up. She hits the middle of the pack, she's denied a breakthrough. Big Tall Jock leaps around the inside, manages to stay in bounds, so she's through for lead. And Feral Fairy skips through on the inside, but there was a cut there, so she's sent to the bin. So it's a power jam for Newcastle. Big Tall Jock tries to go on the inside, she's pushed to the outside, but she manages to stop herself. She skips, and no, she does get pushed off to the inside, but she's through on the outside, and she scoots around the last line of defence. She's through for a full 5, calls off the jam. It's a power jam start for Newcastle. So the score should stand now at 10 to Newcastle and 8 now to Leeds. And Leeds will start with a blocker and the jammer in the bin. So it's a 4-on-3 advantage to Newcastle, as well as a power jam. We've got a 2-wall with a bolsterer, and if you look on the outside, there's the ever-present threat of offence from Missy Popo, and the inside from Ellie Mental. Ellie Mental successfully opens the inside. Penny Bizarre scoots straight through. Just round turn 2, she's through for lead for Newcastle. And once again, we've got Newcastle hanging around for some offence. Full offence means the whole pack is moving forward. But although Penny is knocked off, the blocker who knocked her off was down, so she can come straight back on track. No pass, no penalty, she will not get that point. And she's knocked to the ground, but did she cut? Yes, maybe she did, so she's recycling herself. Back behind the Leeds blockers there, as Penny tries to push on the outside. Spangled is sent to the box for a penalty, didn't quite catch. It's closely followed by Ellie Mental. And the Leeds blockers are reforming in front of Penny at ever-increasing speeds to stop her getting back in a scoring position. But she's through. She's through for 5 points, but closely followed by the Feral Fairy, who's out of the bin now. So Feral Fairy is through for a scoring pass. But Penny Bizarre, no doubt, will try and get a couple of points before she calls it. But no call is forthcoming. She's fighting to get past those blockers. She's pushed from the outside to the inside, but the inside is denied. The Newcastle blockers are busy being offended, as it were, by Leeds as it is. So at the end of that pass, that worked in Leeds' favour in the end. That's 4 points to Leeds and 2 points. And 2 points to Newcastle. So Newcastle increasing the lead slightly there by 7 points. So we've got Newcastle roller goals on 17. Sorry, no, so that takes Leeds to 10. So yeah, 7 points. Score differential, an empty bin, so it's 4-on-4. We've got Sly jamming for Newcastle up against
Why do Leeds jammers always hide from me? Against. I'll tell you in a second, but yeah. Look at the force from Sly, pushing her way through the inside, past turn one, she's pushing, she can't stop Sly. Absolutely unstoppable, she's through for lead for Newcastle. The determination on her face was so obvious there, but Jones, it's Sally Jones jamming for Leeds. She manages to get through for a scoring pass on turn four, but Sly's through on a scoring pass now. She goes for the middle of the wall. Is she breaking through the last line of defence? She pushes on the inside, yes she does. Gets the 4 points, calls off the jam. 4 points to Newcastle, 0 to Leeds. So that takes Leeds, Newcastle to 21 and Leeds remain on 10. The determination on Sly's face there spoke volumes. And once again, a penalty free jam that was. So we've got 4 on 4. We've got a hex wall at the front from Leeds. And in the back, we've only got a single bolster in the form of Missy Popo. Gwyn Fear is jamming. A multiplayer block is called on a Leeds blocker there as Rapunzel is pushed to the outside. Oh! Looks like Jerome Bomb tried to take her out with her shoulder, but she did skip. It was very close to being called as a low blocker, I think, but no call is present. Gwyn Fear is pushed to the outside, and a cut is indeed called. So it's a power jam to Rapunzel for Leeds. And Newcastle Royal Girls can't reform quickly enough. A last hit attempt by Ellie Mental is evaded by Rapunzel, who gets through for lead jammer. So a power jam to Leeds. She calls for offence, but she trips over, looks like trips over, hit one, pearl one. But she does manage to get through at a little 180 reverse. She's through on the inside, she's through for 5 points. She comes through for another scoring pass in this power jam. Interference is being run and the pack is being stretched out. The shoulder of Missy Popo has only a stuttering effect as Rapunzel stays on the outside. She does cut, a cut is called, she's knocked off track by Jarama Bomb, forcing the cut. It's a beautiful little play by Jarama Bomb, very, very sure of where she was pushing the jammer there. But they have 4 points to Leeds to Newcastle 0. So the Newcastle jammer will stay in the bin for the start of this jam as a power jam to Leeds. 4 on 3, pack advantage to Newcastle. It's an interesting start. We've got a pivot line start. However, no coherent wall from Newcastle. But they move into position to try and get in the way of Nina, who's jamming for Leeds. And Nina pushes from the outside to the inside with a bit of assistance from the blockers, but she gets through on the outside. You can't get it in her way. The wall broke down. Nina was through on the outside. She knew where she was going. She was going backwards. Nina was through for lead for Newcastle, for Leeds, and Newcastle jammer Gwynnefer is back on track now. And she's pushing against that four wall of Leeds, but some interference has been run by Jin and Sonic. One of the Leeds blockers peeled off to provide offence against the Newcastle jammer, but once again Nina sails through backwards. And needs to be nasty, unable to contain her. So Gwynnefer is through on a scoring pass as well, but that's a 5 point pass. That's a grand slam for Nina. Once again goes through on the outside, but she takes a tumble as she's blocked by Jin and Sonic. Knocked off to the outside, forced to call it off as Gwynnefer was coming in on a scoring pass. So that's 2 points to Leeds and 0 to Newcastle, and a timeout is called by Leeds. Well, that jam did in fact prove to be the lead change there as Newcastle on, oh wait, the scores are changing, but I think no, my mistake, now Newcastle yet indeed on 21 and Leeds on 26, so 5 points in it. With the Leeds skating short today, they've only got, I think, 11 players, 4, 6, 10, 11 players indeed. They'll probably want to utilise the timeouts, if for no other reason than just to get your breath back. Which is, you know, after 10 minutes, it's a good time to take a timeout. But even though they're skating short, they don't seem to be skating light. They're hitting hard, very efficient. And they seem to be very good at providing both defence and offence. So with the
the pivot, the number 16, I think that is. Yeah, that's tripping the velvet, standing in the penalty box. A penalty about to be served. That leaves a 4-3 pack advantage to Newcastle, with the two wall being bolstered at the front for Leeds. We've got Big Tall Jock jamming for Newcastle, and I think that's Immodesty Grays, is it? No, it's not, sorry. It is Sally Jones again jamming for Leeds, and she's through on the outside. No, that's a... Both jammers indeed. Well, there we go. The Leeds jammer being sent off for a back block, for a cut, sorry, and the Newcastle jammer being sent off for a back block. So as Sally Jones was in the box first, she's out first, but followed by Big Tall Jock only a moment later. Big Tall Jock knocked off to the inside there. That was a very tiny cut, but it obviously even a tiny cut is a cut. And a spin round by Sally Jones on the inside there. I mean, she gets through for lead. Sorry, not for lead, because she's been to the gym. Been to the bin. So no lead in this game. So this jam will run for the 2 minutes. But both jammers now on the scoring passes, as a beautiful duo of shoulder checks by Hit One Pearl One is provided. A little apex hop by Big Tall Jock sees her sailing through for 4 points as well. So 4 points each for these jammers, with 49 seconds remaining in this jam. Sally Jones pushed to the outside by Missy Pow Pow, who needs to return to her wall. But Sally Jones testing each side, stretching the pack out from the inside to the outside, while Big Tall Jock is caught up behind that four wall. Another big shoulder check from Missy Pow Pow, unsuccessful, not able to stop Sally Jones. She's through for a 4 point pass, while Big Tall Jock is still struggling to get past the four wall as Sally Jones comes through for another pass once again, manages to duck the shoulder of Missy Pow Pow through for another, this time 5 point. That's a grand slam, she passed the jammer as well. It's a 5 point pass for Sally Jones, extending Leeds lead by 9 points now, as Big Tall Jock manages to break through, but Leeds reform ahead of her before she can get very many more points. But there on that final pass, we had 0 to Leeds and 4 to Newcastle. So these teams staying quite close to each other in terms of points, with Newcastle on 29 and Leeds on 34. We saw Hit One Pearl One go to the box there, but she's standing there, so a penalty is due to be served. So a very brief pack advantage for Leeds, but Hit One Pearl One is back on track before anyone really moves, just in time to perform a little shoulder check on Rapunzel, knocking her off. But Rapunzel straight back on, a double inside hop. It wasn't on the apex, but she jumped around on the inside. Benny Bizarre chasing her down, but that was a beautiful escape by Rapunzel there, and it's through for lead for Leeds. That's going to be very difficult. I will trip over that several times, no doubt, if I haven't already. So Rapunzel coming hot on the outside, calls it off as she tries to sail past Genesonic. How many points will the refs throw up? That's 0 points for that pass. 0 points for Newcastle. Rapunzel claims to have got the 1 point, but it has not been awarded by the... Oh, no, it's been pointed out by the OPR there. That Leeds did in fact get 1 point. So 1 point for Rapunzel and 0 for Penny in that last pass. So there we go, extending the lead. So it's now 10 points in it, with 29 to Newcastle and 39 to Leeds. We've got Sly jamming for Newcastle, and once again the Leeds jammer is crouching out of sight. It's Nina, 88, it's Nina who's going to be jamming for Leeds, but we've got just a quick time out there. I think while the refs double checked that, the score trackers did in fact have the correct point awarded, as it did change when we saw the OPR make the jammer if count the point. So time back in again, with just over half the time remaining in this period. Got an empty bin, so 4-on-4 with Nina jamming for Leeds against Sly for Newcastle, and Sly straight for the inside. A beautiful shoulder to the chest of Riggs, but that's a high block. It's a high block that's called, so she's to the bin. 30 seconds for high block. Nina's through on before turn one. So Newcastle need to hold this jam to deny any points for Nina to stop them running away with this power jam. But Nina blasts through in lane two, but the hips of Missy Popo knock her off to the inside. But Newcastle reform, and they do manage to contain her while Leeds are holding back to try and stretch that pack out. But with Newcastle holding Nina pretty well, it's going to be difficult. Oh, and she managed to stay in it once again. The shoulder of Missy Popo just failing to knock the jammer off track. Two falls from blockers allow Nina to get through. And she comes through again for another. Oh, but this time the shoulder of Missy Popo finds its anchor. I don't know why I said anchor. Finds its place, knocking Nina down and out, forcing the recycle. Nina seems to favour. They're going through backwards, but the hips of D-Rama Bomb come through. Recycled by Spangled. Spangled pulls her back, forcing the recycle. Further back as the Newcastle Roller Girls blockers reform in front. Slides back on track now. She's forced also to recycle. And she's knocked off by the shoulder of Zero Feral Fairy. And she is recycled back to behind turn one. As D-Rama Bomb is sent to the box for a penalty I missed. But both jammers now recycled back to way beyond turn one. And Riggs there sent to the bin for a forearms penalty. Sly is now through. She was through to score. Leeds called off the jam. There's a 5-point pass for Leeds and zero for Newcastle. So there we go. That's really increased the lead of Leeds by now 21 points. And we've got one of each blocker in the bin, so it's a 3-on-3 start. And we see Guinevere jamming for Newcastle up against that's Rapunzel jamming for Leeds, and she's so fast from the inside to the outside, fast and strong. That's everything a jammer needs to be. She's up against the last line of defense in Jin. She's turning her body, denying the strength in Jin's shoulders. She pushes her on the inside, manages to get through for Leeds. Lead for Leeds as Gwyn breaks to the last line of defense of Leeds, and she's through to score. Buxley's sent to the box for a penalty there. And there we have 4 points for Leeds and zero for Newcastle. So once again, Leeds increasing their lead. We've now got Newcastle standing at 29 and Leeds Roller Girls at 54. We've got a pivot line start. Again, 3-on-3 with one blocker apiece in the box. Big Tall Jock jamming for Newcastle. I think that must be Sally Jones jamming for Leeds. So a bit of a sprint start, perhaps. A false start called on, I think that was Feral Fairy, who needs to yield. She has yielded. Sally Jones disrupts the Newcastle wall. Gets around Ellie Mantle on the outside. Meanwhile, Big Tall Jock manages to push through the inside of Feral Fairy to get through, but Leeds have the lead again. Big Tall Jock is chasing her down, but she's a good quarter of a lap behind as Feral Fairy easily passes on the inside. Calls off the jam before Big Tall Jock can score any points whatsoever, so that's 4 points to Leeds and zero to Newcastle. So Leeds really successfully exploiting the power of lead jammer, essentially. They get lead first, well, obviously, get lead, get some points, call it off every time, 3, 4, 5 points to nothing, it adds up. And in this case, it adds up for 29 to Newcastle and 58 to Leeds. And we've got Penny Bizarre jamming for Newcastle against Nina for Leeds. And Newcastle, that wall moving to stop Nina, but a block from Liz goes through the jammer, knocking Anita Benasti to the floor. They managed to recycle, but is the inside been left open for Nina to get through? Yes, it has. I think Nina got lead, did she? Okay. Yes, indeed, Leeds have got lead, but Penny Bizarre is ahead for Newcastle. The pack speed is fast, it has speeded up. So with Penny Bizarre sprinting ahead, Nina has no other choice really but to call it off. That's a 0-0 jam.
That was going very, very quickly indeed. So next up, with everybody out of the bin, we've got a 4-on-4. No, I beg your pardon. Leeds have a blocker in the bin. So we've got a 4-on-3 pack advantage. We've got Sly jamming for Newcastle up against Rapunzel for Leeds. And some jammer on jammer action from Rapunzel there. She tries to knock Sly off to the outside. Unsuccessfully though, as Sly manages to duck around the outside, going to the inside. She pushes through the inside. She stays in. Burns, yes, she does. So Sly is through for Leeds as Rapunzel tries to get around the outside of Missy Popo. She successfully does. Knocking Ellie Mental to the floor. She's chasing Sly down now. And in an exact carbon copy but reversal of the previous jam, as Rapunzel was gaining, Sly took the nod from the bench to call it off before anybody could lose any points. So a 0-0 jam once more. No change in the scores. 29 Newcastle, 58 to Leeds. There's 29 points in it. So yeah, they do indeed have double the score currently. Leeds are in the lead by 100%. Once more, Leeds starting one blocker down as Guinevere is jamming against Leeds. A beautiful little strut to the outside there for Guinevere, but she does put her foot out. Needs to recycle. It was so close to being through the lead. And similarly, Sally Jones for Leeds is knocked to the inside as Newcastle wall reforms. The shoulder of Anita finds the chest of Sally Jones, and the shoulder of Gin and Sonic keeps her in the middle. The hips of Eek knock her off to the inside. She has to recycle back behind Anita, who tries to knock her off to the outside, but that is an out. That is a direction of gameplay, sorry, a clockwise block for Bucks Liz, who sent to the bin for it. Guinevere is through on a scoring pass now with lead jammer as she desperately tries to push through, but she is knocked down and out by what I think that was Sally Jones actually, who also went out. So Gwyn aims for the middle of the pack with two blockers now in the bin for Newcastle and only one in the bin for Leeds. Sally Jones jumps around the outside, but a cut is called. She is cutting, so this is a power jam, ever so briefly a power jam to Newcastle. That's no points to Leeds and 3 points to Newcastle, I believe that was. So this will start as a power jam. So Newcastle managing to close the gap slightly, denying Leeds points there. That's 33 to Newcastle and 58 to Leeds Rollerdolls. And we have, let's see, well, we've got a 3-on-2 pack advantage for Leeds now, with the looming offense of both Missy Popo and Elemental again. Big tall jock scoots around the outside, gets lead after turn one, and Buxley's rejoins the track. So we've got 3-on-4 now, as Leeds still have the advantage. Some offense being tried by the whole of the Newcastle Roller Girls. Gin and Sonic's now joining the track after serving a penalty. Big Tall Jump pulls the blockers to the outside, leaving a gap on the inside. She scoots around. Can she stay in? Yes, she can. A little hop and a skip. She's through on the outside for a grand slam. Sally Jones is now back on track, but will be on her initial pass. So no immediate hurry for Big Tall Jump to call this jam off, as she's once again pushed from the outside to the inside. She's passed two of the four blockers, passed three of the four blockers, but she's just knocked on the outside. No pass, no penalty. She gets through for 4 points. So it looks like a star pass has been done by Leeds. So now we've got Tripping the Velvet, number 16 for Leeds, with the star in her hand. Big Tall Jock tries to get some points. She's knocked off to the inside. Takes 3 points, calls the jam, denies Leeds points. So let's have a look what that's done to the scores. Well, there we go. Newcastle Roller Girls closing the gap by a fair margin there. We've got 45 to Newcastle. And no change for Leeds there on 58. So only 13 points in it now, with just under 6 minutes to go in this half. And now we have, with one Leeds blocker in the bin, we've got a 4-on-3 advantage to Newcastle. We've got Penny Bazaar jamming against Rapunzel. And Rapunzel, a powerhouse, pushing against the shoulder of Gin. She successfully does so, but meanwhile, Penny Bazaar has taken the inside for Leeds for Newcastle. And we've got Rapunzel closing that gap as we've got a fast pack while the blockers battle for supremacy. Who's going to get to the front? Get to the front, slow down the pack, let your jammer through, stop their jammer. That's the name of the game. The leads blocker, but no, the leads blocker tried, Mazda de Grace tried to get in the way of Penny Bazaar. Unsuccessfully, she skipped on the inside, got the 1 point, called off the jam. That was 1 to Newcastle and 0 to Leeds. A last minute juke by Penny Bazaar, got that 1 point, and now we have an official review. An official review by Newcastle, it looks like. So with just under 5 minutes remaining in this period, an official review has been called. I don't know what the problem is. As soon as I find out, I shall let you know. But yeah, this bout so far has been fast, frantic and hard. Neither team obviously willing to give an inch. Both teams really want this victory, and with Leeds skating short as well, they must be tiring, but they're showing no signs of it whatsoever. They seem to be running a 1-in-3 jam rotation, and with only 11 players that leads to some tired blockers as well. And with the number of fast packs we've had as well, that really demonstrates the fitness of this team. And looks like in this next jam we're going to have Nina jamming for Leeds up against Sly for Newcastle. Both jammers proving to be formidable in their roles. Sorry about that, I was just getting confirmation of the official review. Newcastle claimed that a cut should have been called on the jammer Rapunzel. However, the jammer touched the line, did not cross it, so no cut remains. The official review is unsuccessful. So once the referees are back in place, the jam should be ready to commence. So time in. Once again, we've got an empty penalty box, so we've got 4-on-4 with Leeds taking a hex wall position at the front. We've got Sly against Nina, and Nina trying to push Sly to the outside, but unsuccessfully so, managed to spin around, taking a second to regroup. Sly digs in with the shoulder and pushes that wall out of the way, tripping the velvet, tries to rejoin to reform, but she's pushing through. And she, last line of defence, she managed to get through on the inside, she really determined to get through for Leeds there, that's Leeds to Sly for Newcastle. Meanwhile, Nina is trapped at the back of just on turn one. De Ramon tries to knock her off to the inside, on the outside, sorry, but she does manage to get through on the inside. Meanwhile, Ellie Mantle and Hit One Pearl One have reformed at the front to get in the way of Nina to stop her getting through the pack. While Sly is now on a scoring pass, she's pushed off to the outside, tries to climb back through that pack. She's on the inside now. That looks like one of the blockers is trying to call a cut on Sly. It was not called. She's through, that was tripping the velvet, so she's through again for a 5 point pass as Nina, the jammer for Leeds, is recycled once more behind the wall of Newcastle Roller Girls. And Sly is through for another scoring pass. She goes through with her shoulder, she's knocked off balance, and there was a blocking to the head penalty on 72 Riggs. So Sly is through for another grand slam. These points are really needed by Newcastle. Canny Belters, she's through for another scoring pass as Nina is pushed off once again on the outside by Missy Popo. Sly is knocked down but not out by Carnage, I think that was. She's through past tripping the velvet. She's through for one more grand slam. There we go, with 27 seconds remaining. Can there be another one? A mistimed hit from DeRamabomb sees her knocked to the floor, but then Nina closely followed. Also knocked to the floor. Star pass has taken place. So is that tripping the velvet? I think they'll be wearing the star now. She's through for a scoring pass. As Sly comes through, she calls it off, denying any points to Leeds there, but that was an amazing few passes by Sly there. 2 points in that final pass to 0 for Leeds. And there has been a lead change. Yes, there has. Newcastle Roller Girls are on 60. And Leeds Roller Dolls are on 58.
I think that was an official review there called by, yep, official review called by Leeds. I think this might well be calling a cut by Tripping the Velvet, possibly on Sly, the Newcastle jammer on turn three, I believe it was. That would be my guess anyway. If I get clarification, I will surely let you know, but they may well be calling a cut with the not being called on the Newcastle jammer in that jam. So with a little over 3 minutes remaining on the period clock, this has been, as I said, a very fast, furious and exciting bout so far. We knew coming in that these teams were going to be very well matched. So with only 4 points currently separating the teams, everything to play for. Both teams demonstrating some excellent teamwork, some excellent tactics, and some extremely strong jammers. Looks like in the next jam we will have Gwynfyr jamming for Newcastle up against Feral Fairy for Leeds. Although this could change, but at the moment they are wearing the stars. And with one blocker apiece in the box, it'll be a 3-on-3 start. As it stands, as I say, this could change. This official review taking some time to reach a conclusion, although I'm sure many of you out there will know full well that this is by no means a long official review. They are known to last a while sometimes. With the referees in the huddle, needed to get the evidence of what each referee saw, pool them, find out what we can ostensibly refer to as the facts, and decide on the best course of action. They're in, yeah, apparently so. So yeah, as I said once more, if I'm informed, because obviously ordinarily the live announcers are informed by a referee spokesperson of the course for any official reviews. However, with this stream announcing being separate and new, they don't always remember, but if they do, I will surely pass this on. But yeah, this streaming now being provided by Tyne and Fear for both Tyne and Fear Games and Newcastle Roller Girls as often as we possibly can, really. Obviously, it means carting quite a bit of kit to different venues, but whenever it's possible, we will try and do it, because obviously it's a great way to see a game that you can't attend. I'm just getting confirmation for the official review now. So I've just had confirmation that Leeds did in fact question a blocking to the head penalty, but the call stands. The official review is unsuccessful. Absolutely no change. So yeah, the jammers are still the same as before. So we've got Gwynfyr of Jamalot for Newcastle up against Feral Fairy for Leeds with 3-on-3. Although there is further deliberation going on between a referee and I think that's Rigger Morris that's in the box. Possibly. So the time out of the official review is still in effect, so maybe the decision is being questioned perhaps. Here we know we're timing again. No, I'm not sure what the further delay was, but there we go, we're back in time now. 5 seconds is called and we're underway. A little bit of contact there from the jammers as Feral Fairy tries to knock Gwynfyr off to the outside. unsuccessfully, but she does manage to get through on the outside herself for lead jammer. So Leeds have lead in this jam, but Guinevere is now about half a lap behind. Trying to break through the pack for a scoring pass now. Farrell Ferry successfully manages to get past. Needs to be nasty, but the shoulder of Eek does knock her off to the outside, but not before she manages to get 4 points. Paul's off the jam, 4 points to Leeds and zero to Newcastle. They did manage to run the jam long enough to get their blocker out of the bin. So now there is a 4-on-3 pack advantage to Leeds. The scores are neck and neck now with 62 apiece, with just over 2 minutes remaining in this period. We've got Big Tall Jock jamming for Newcastle up against... who is that? Is that Rapunzel? Yes, it is Rapunzel jamming for Leeds. Big Tall Jock pushing against the middle as Rapunzel... so strong and so fast, pushing from the outside to the inside, and she's through. Elemental takes a knee. Rapunzel is through for lead for Leeds. Immodesty Grays takes a penalty for cutting, sent to the bin, and Big Tall Jock is now through the pack. But just as Rapunzel comes up against the back of the Canny Belters pack, she's knocked off to the inside by Missy Popo, denying her points for that lip pass. Big Tall Jock trying a last little sprint to get some points. Leeds getting one on that pass. Newcastle denied any points at all. So that makes a score differential of one. 62 to Newcastle and 63 to Leeds. With a minute and a half remaining. This is exciting. Do I sound excited? I'll try and sound more excited. This is exciting! Now we've got, I can't see the penalty box, but judging by the lineup, we've got a 4-on-3 pack advantage to Newcastle. We've got Sly jamming against Nina. Sly pushing against the chest of Carnage, pushing on the outside, she knocks to the inside, she manages to stay and gets past the shoulders, a bit of assistance from Buxliz, she's through for lead. Newcastle have lead. Nina is now up against the last 2 points of wall, they need to be nasty, and Buxliz, they separate the wall, a last ditch attempt by Buxliz, but that's way out of play. And she needs to get back to it, will she get back to the wall in time to block effectively before Nina is through on a scoring pass? Sly is knocked back, knocked off to the outside. Needs to get through for a scoring pass, but Nina is through for 4 points. Slides through on the inside for what I'm assuming is going to be 4 points. Yes, that's right. But now with Nina in the lead, but with Sly having lead, Sly really needs to catch up while the blockers need to hold that jammer. Sly's not going to call it while the other jammer is ahead. She's pushed off to the inside by whoever that was, I'm not sure, but she all breaking through the shoulders there of Immodesty Grays. And I think that was Feral Fairy. And she's through for another 4 points. With Nina still trapped behind the three wall. Behind Bucks, Liz, and Anita being nasty now. She tries to break through. Anita tries to knock her off to the inside, unsuccessfully so she's through for 4 points, but closely followed by. Sly now, who is 1 point ahead, she calls off the jam. So on that last pass, 4 points to Newcastle. Has that been another lead change? Yes, I think it has. I think there's 3 points in it now. As we go into half time, we have 74 to Newcastle. And I think that's... anything changes? I will certainly inform you. But yes, we've got a 50-minute half-time now, or 14 and a half minutes from now. So I'm sure if you've seen any of this game, you will be absolutely gripped. So no, I don't need to tell you to not go anywhere. Well, obviously you can go somewhere for 15 minutes. We'll make sure you come back within 15 minutes, within 14 minutes, for the exciting conclusion of this British Champs game. Newcastle Roller Girls and Leeds Roller Girls, the whole game, neck and neck. Brief lead of 20 or so points by Leeds that has been slowed and indeed stalled now by Newcastle. But yes, I think the scores stand. 74 to Newcastle, 71 to Leeds. So make sure you come back within 14 minutes for the conclusion of this half.
Hello everyone, we're back for the second period of this amazing Roller Derby British Champs game of Newcastle Canny Belters versus Leeds Roller Dolls. And apologies for the hurried start once again. Not that I wasn't paying attention or anything, I just wasn't paying attention.
I didn't get that, I'm zoomed in over there.
Don't
worry.
So,
no gratuitous shots.
We've got one Leeds blocker in the box, so we will have a 4-on-3 pack advantage start for Newcastle. And we've got Guinevere with a very casual stance there, waiting for the whistle, jamming against Rapunzel for Leeds. We're just waiting for the whistle before we begin. There it is. Time is in. And as soon as the jam timer is in position, we will have 5 seconds, no doubt, and we will begin the second half of this game with the score standing 74 to Newcastle and Leeds on 71. And Guinevere is through on the inside, but is she knocked off? No, she's not. She's straight back through, pushing against the middle. Ferrell very spins around and tries to block her with her back. She successfully does both on turn one now, and neither jammer really making any progress, but Rapunzel does manage to get past Durama Bomb. Guinevere has one left to beat, and Guinevere is through for lead for Newcastle. Meanwhile, Rapunzel has got Missy Pepper to beat, which she does on the inside, so she's about a half lap behind Guinevere. As Guinevere comes in for a scoring pass, but she's knocked off and down by Carnage. Calls off the jam, but not before she scores 3 points, denying Leeds any points at all. That is 3 more to Newcastle and 0 to Leeds, so that's 77 place, 71 to Newcastle. So with the Leeds blocker still in the bin, we've again got a 4-on-3 pack advantage to Newcastle, with Penny Bizarre jamming for Newcastle up against, I think that might be Nina, but I can't see. Yes, it is, there she is, Nina. Penny Bizarre goes from the inside towards the outside, but is tried to get it, Modesty Grace tries to block her unsuccessfully. Penny Bizarre is through for lead. While Nina does break through the wall of Newcastle, just seconds behind her, about maybe a quarter lap, but Penny Bizarre gets through unencumbered, as it were, for a score of 4 on that pass, while Nina goes up against the four wall of Newcastle, which is moving and evolving and adapting. She's not yet scored on the scoring pass. Some offense provided by Riggs does momentarily get in the way of Gin and Sonic, who comes off on the inside to make sure that she didn't get called for a cutting penalty. Penny Bizarre doing some amazing spinning around from the inside to the outside, but she is knocked off by Feral Fairy, recycled back towards turn two, while Nina is still stretching the pack out but desperately trying to get past the last two in the wall, which is Bucks, Liz and Anita B. Nasty. Meanwhile, Penny Bizarre sails through once again on the inside, while Feral Fairy tries to provide some offense on Bucks, Liz. Nina goes up against the shoulder of Anita B. Nasty and is knocked back, so once again the wall of Newcastle reforms. With the last two, Anita B. Nasty and Bucks Liz. Anita B. Nasty, does she knock her off to the inside? Yes, she does, so once again she is recycled as Penny Bizarre gets through for another Grand Slam. Really racking up points in this jam now as a star pass has taken place, because Nina has indeed passed the star, because I saw her join a wall and I thought, well, why is she doing that? Well, she's not wearing a star. It's because she has passed the star to Feral Fairy, who is being recycled back behind Gin and Sonic and Bucks Liz. Gin and Sonic tries to go for the shoulder. She's knocked down by Feral Fairy, who sprints on the inside, tries a little apex hop, goes down and receives a cut. She does cut the track. Newcastle get 4 points. Will any points be awarded to Leeds? Yes, they will. 4 points to Leeds. So 4 points scored in the whole jam by Leeds, and a total of, I think it might have been 14, possibly even 19 points by Newcastle, but they, nevertheless, Newcastle have hit the century with 100 to Leeds 75. Equal packs now, but a power jam start. Big Tall Jock is jamming alone for Newcastle. Carnage blocks, but she blocks to the floor by turn two. Big Tall Jock is out as lead jammer for Newcastle. A full 30 seconds will be served for this power jam. Offense goes in for by Ellie Mantle and Missy Popo. Ellie on the outside and Missy Popo on the inside. The blocker sweeps towards the inside, leaving the outside open, while Big Tall Jock jumps to the outside, slowly extending this pack. She's through on the inside, she's through for a pass of five, just as Feral Fairy comes on to jam, having served the penalty. So Feral Fairy now providing fifth blocker service, and knocking Big Tall Jock off to the inside, but then has to try and get through the wall of blockers of Newcastle. The shoulder of Missy Popo knocking her off to the outside, just knocking her off balance, forcing the recycle. As Missy Popo now skates forward, and the pack collapses back into a four wall, and she needs to start all over again. She's pushing on the middle. Feral Fairy's pushing on the middle, but an inside gap is left open. However, I think that was hit one, Pearl one, that actually knocked off to the inside. She did skate off track, so needs to come back in behind Pearl. Meanwhile, that looks like a high block is called on Big Tall Jock, so she's sent to the bin to a power jam to Leeds. But Feral Fairy not having any luck getting past this wall of blockers. Missy Popo and Ellie Mantle working in tandem, knocking her off to the outside, then recycling her. Now all four Newcastle blockers are recycling her back as the Leeds blocker is sent to the bin there. So Feral Fairy once again up against the shoulder of Missy Popo with support from Hit One Pearl One. With Ellie Mantle and Spangled up front, keeping the Leeds jump, the Leeds blockers at bay, while Big Tall Jock has taken the track once again with 5 seconds remaining. Can she score any more points? The question is asked, and the answer is yes, she can, because she did. 5 of them. 5 points to Newcastle, no points to Leeds. In the nick of time, that's how you define it. After that jam, we've got a Newcastle Roller Girls on a 110, and Leeds Roller Girls still on 75. So Newcastle really picking up and running away with it now. Leeds need to claw back some of these points, because there's a 35 point differential that's crept into the scores now. And there's a team timeout being called by Leeds, so we've got a minute. Actually only 35 seconds, it takes me a while to notice these things, sorry. We've only got 30 seconds remaining in the timeouts, while Leeds no doubt discuss tactics, or maybe just having a rest, or exactly how best to combat the more effective teamwork and tactics of Newcastle. So both teams obviously benefit from the minute rest. It doesn't seem very much, but every minute counts. Every second of that minute counts. I'm sure many of you out there who play this sport know how tiring it is. Skating fast is one thing. Skating fast while people are trying to hit you it does add to the strain. So that's the timeout done. We're ready to begin with two Leeds blockers in the bin. A 4-on-2 advantage to Newcastle. And we've got Sly jamming for Newcastle against Rapunzel for Leeds. It's 5 seconds in and we're underway. Rapunzel trying to break through the inside. Blocked straight away. Sly's through on the outside without any problem. And Buxley's trying to block Rapunzel, who is sent to the bin for... Is that a back block? Yes, it is a back block. So a power jam to Sly for Newcastle. She's through for a score of 5. And we've got a 3-on-3 now. We've lost the Newcastle blocker. Offense is supplied by Anita Benasti. Skates through from the middle to the outside. And the Newcastle blockers desperately trying to stop Immodesty Grace from retaking position, allowing the pack to spread out, so that Sly has unfettered access to some more points. Sly calling off there for a few seconds, but it was called before any other points could be amassed in the opposition. So that was another 5 point pass. And 0-2 lead. So Newcastle once again extend their lead to 120. To Leeds remain on 75. So yeah, we still have one Leeds blocker in the bin. So we got a 4-on-3 advantage to Newcastle, but it's also a power jam. The Leeds jammer is missing. I can't see her in the bin. Oh, she's standing, sorry, I beg your pardon. So yes, of course, Rapunzel was serving the remainder of her penalty, but not before she can't be... Oh, a beautiful shoulder from Missy Popo sends Rapunzel flying off the inside. Oh, Guinevere straight out for lead. She's trying to get the points now on the outside. Can't she keep going on the outside? Outside to the inside, to the middle. She's like a pinball being bounced around, but Rapunzel is still struggling to get through this pack of Newcastle. She hits the shoulder of Pearl. She's testing the waters on the inside against Duramo, but the inside is opened up, but then closed quickly by Ellie Menzel and Missy Pow Pow. But Rapunzel's trying to sneak around the inside. However, she's through for, no, another cut. So a penalty I missed there on Guinevere. But Rapunzel will now replace Guinevere in the box. Guinevere will be released, and Rapunzel will serve the time that Guinevere sat for. A beautiful bit of offense from Durama Bomb there. On I think that's Killer Roo, stopping her from effectively blocking the Newcastle jammer, and Guinevere getting through for a pass, a Grand Slam pass. She's getting through on the outside there, knocks the pivot off the outside. A forearms penalty called on Missy Popo there, but with Rapunzel being back on track, she's now in a scoring position as Guinevere is recycled back. Will she try and get the points and call it off, or will she let it run? With only two blockers left to get in the way of Rapunzel, they being Ellie Mental and Durama Bomb. Rapunzel coming through that block, holding her face. Didn't actually see any contact made, but Ellie Mental is also down. And yet we seem to have a skater not standing straight away, so there's an injury where we always stop for injured, and every time we have a boat, we have medics on hand. Today it's St John Ambulance, three of them straight to the scene. All care will be provided. I will update on how this goes, but obviously we don't want to concentrate on the injured skater, on the down skater. So as a sign of respect, the referees always block the scene and the skaters take a knee. But as currently the scores stand, 129 to Newcastle, really running away with the lead now against 79 to Leeds. So it seems that in that jam, two skaters sustained an injury, one on each team. That was Rapunzel for Leeds, who came through holding her face as if she'd taken a hit to the face, and Ellie Mental, who didn't get back up after hitting the deck. But there we have Ellie Mental's back up and skated off track under her own power, as the jam was called off because of this injury. She will not be allowed to retake the track to play for three jams, obviously, if she decides to at all. But like I say, she did retake the track under her own power, so I don't think it's anything particularly too serious. I haven't seen Rapunzel. There doesn't seem to be any follow-up to her possible injury, so hopefully everything is okay there too. Now we have two Newcastle blockers in the bin, so it's a 4-on-2 pack advantage to Leeds, and we've got Penny Bazaar jamming against, who is that? Tripping the Velvet? Yes it is. And it looks like the Newcastle pivot has lost their helmet cover. With Tripping the Velvet getting lead there, Penny Bazaar is just through for a scoring pass as Tripping the Velvet skates out of bounds and with a low block, knocking, I think it was Gin and Sonic, was it maybe, down to the ground. That's a low block, so it's now going to be a power jam to Newcastle. So Penny Bazaar needs to capitalise on this with 30 seconds without an opposing jam, and she's through for 5 points. So with all blockers out of the bin now, Newcastle and Leeds both are 4 on the floor. Penny Bazaar skates slowly in towards the outside. Some offence is provided on the inside, but it is filled quickly. So she scoots around the outside again, manages to get past the shoulders of Carnage. She's through for another 5. So we got Feral Fairy waiting on the outside there, ready to provide defense, but she does move back into position as Tripping the Velvet, as Jammer retakes the track. She's pushing towards the rear of Anita B. Nasty, and then against the rear of Hit One Pearl One, but she pushes through the inside, gets past them, round on the outside. She's through now for a scoring pass of 4 points. As Penny tries to get through for another pass. Does she succeed? She's knocked off to the outside by, I think that's Feral Fairy. And so she's recycling back as Tripping the Velvet comes through for another score pass. But that's the shoulder of Missy Firefly once again. Stops her still, knocks her to the ground, and then Missy reforms in front of her while the rest of the Newcastle blockers reform also. And Need to Be Nasty forcing her off track to the outside. Then all the blockers do the same old thing, recycling her back, spreading out the pack, making her recycle all the way back to beyond turn four. While Penny tries to push through the pack. That's a 5-point pass for each jammer in that jam there. So what's that done for the scores? That's 144 to Newcastle against 88 to Leeds. With 18 and a half minutes remaining in this game. All is still to play for, but Newcastle are really running away with the lead now. As the next jam is underway, we've got Sly jamming against. That's Sally Jones for Leeds. Both walls seem pretty tough as the jammers are knocked from inside to outside. But Buxley's mistimes a hit. Sally Jones goes around the outside, gets lead. Sly is desperately trying to push from the inside to the outside. Nina is blocking him the outside. She does get past her on the outside. So Sly is through on a scoring pass, but not before Sally Jones is through. A quick little juke there. She goes around the outside. That's a score of four for the pass. Sly comes in for a scoring pass, but not before Sally Jones calls off the jam. 4 points to Leeds, no points to Newcastle. That closes the gap ever so slightly. That's 144 to Newcastle, plays 90 to Leeds. That was a fast jam indeed. So yeah, we've got Rapunzel back on track as jammer, so hopefully any injury she may have sustained is okay. With an empty box, we've got 4-on-4. We've got Rapunzel jamming for Leeds up against, that's Big Tall Jock jamming for Newcastle. Rapunzel knocked off to the inside, so recycled back as Big Tall Jock also knocked off. Doesn't want to take any chances, so recycles back behind everybody. Meanwhile, Rapunzel tries to squeeze through the inside of Rapunzel. Takes Spangled out. Spangled goes down. Low block is called. Unintentional, but that's the way it goes. Spangled goes to the box for a low block. Rapunzel is through for lead jammer. Big Tall Jock being recycled again on the inside. Looks like she's picked up a penalty as well, and it is a high block. So it's a power jam now for Leeds and Rapunzel, with the last two blockers for Newcastle, rejoined by Missy Popo. So there's a three wall trying to get in the way of Rapunzel, who powers through. Some offense is provided by Feral Fairy. Derailment and Hit One Pearl One managed to reform in front of her. The shoulder of Hit One Pearl One knocks her off balance, but she does not go down or out. Rapunzel is through on the outside for another score of 5. Big Tall Jock is standing up in the box now, so less than 10 seconds remaining on the penalty as Spangled rejoins the track as the blocker. A star has come off the head of Rapunzel. A star pass is no doubt going to be attempted, but looks like the pivot has no clue that this was a plan. But luckily manages to successfully pass the star as Tripping the Velvet gets knocked down by, that's right, the shoulder of Missy Popo. Knocked down on the inside. She's pushing desperately, trying to get through. Some offense provided by Feral Fairy, but not in the right place for her to actually take advantage of. She's through on the outside, she manages to stay in. Pearl, last line of defence, can she stop her? Can she slow her down enough to get some help? Missy Popo not quite arriving in the time needed as Tripping the Velvet is through, but has not quite put the star in yet, so can't score any points. Can she get it on in time? Yes, maybe she can. And knocked down again by the shoulder of Missy Popo. Tripping the Velvet spins around Spangled, who moves on the inside to reform, spins around again, slows down to keep the pack. That was a no-point pass for Leeds. So they really started racking up the points there, Leeds. I believe they got 16 points in that jump. And Newcastle got none. So yeah, 18 points I think it was. It's 144 to Newcastle, plays 100 to Leeds with their 15 minutes remaining, everything to play for. 4-on-4, it's an empty box. And we've got, who have we got jamming? We've got Guinevere jamming for Newcastle, spinning through on the outside. Oh, she manages to sustain track of the hit from Nina. Immodesty grazes centre of the bin. And Guinevere is through for lead for Newcastle as Sally Jones is recycled from a hit to the inside by, I think that was Bucks Liz. Guinevere is now through for a scoring pass. Sally Jones is trying to get round Jin and Sonic, which she does manage to do, but then Jin and Sonic manages to reform. Sally Jones goes for it. Was that Sally Jones? Sorry. No, it wasn't. That was Carnage, I think, going for a hit on Guinevere. Knocking off the inside, but she's up first. She's through. Another scoring pass. Last hit by Nina. No effect, really. Guinevere is straight through for another pass of 4 points. And Sally Jones is now through as well. She'll be scoring on this pass. But Guinevere sails through the pack on the inside. She doesn't call it off. Sally Jones comes through, hits the shoulder of Jin, spins around. She does knock her off balance long enough to take advantage of her position. However, the Newcastle blockers do manage to reform her. However, she manages to get around them again. So Sally Jones through for what's looking like a very tiring pass, but for 4 points, it was worth it. Guinevere recycled once more, forced to call off the jam. 2 points to Newcastle, and the 4 points for Leeds. So we've got 150 for Newcastle play. No, 153, I beg your pardon, for Newcastle plays 104. It's got up again. 154 for Newcastle plays 104 for Leeds. With just over 13 minutes remaining, we have. Is it a timeout? Is it an official review? I think it's an official review. Yes. An official review. And I think, yeah, there's one Leeds blocker in the bin standing and one Newcastle blocker in the bin sitting. So we have a 3-on-3 equal pack disadvantage or advantage, whichever way you want to look at it. And we have Sly jamming for Newcastle against Rapunzel jamming for Leeds. As always, as if I find out what the problem may be with this official review, I will of course let you know. I should say as well, I have been informed that we did actually drop out of service for the last 10 minutes of the close of the first half, and I can only apologise for that. I did not know at the time. I was still providing the commentary. Evidently, I was essentially talking to myself, which isn't entirely unusual. But I believe we're back up and running now, so if you did wonder what had happened, apologies. Like I said before, it is teething troubles at the moment. Once we're more used to exactly how to provide the streaming service, it will become much more fluid and much more, dare I use the word, professional, because you know we want this to be as good as possible. We want it to be a professional representation of Roller Derby. You know, everybody involved loves this sport so much, we want to provide you with the best possible coverage. I'm just going to get some confirmation of the official review. Okay, so yes, the confirmation of that official review was that there was excuse me there was a problem with the possibility of the blocking a down skater call. However, the call stands. The official review is unsuccessful because the call stands. The skater was blocked while she was down. Black 5-2. So the call remains. So as I said, we have 3-on-3. 3-on-3 pack. Time is in. We have Rapunzel jamming for Leeds up against Sly jamming for Newcastle. Leeds are at the front of the two wall being bolstered by Missy Pow Pow. And a very low start from Rapunzel there. A slow start. She's looking for an angle. And then that's the trademark power of Rapunzel. But Diorama Bomb actually manages to knock her off balance. And Sly is through for Newcastle for lead. Rapunzel now tries to get past the last two. Oh, a hip check is missed by Diorama Bomb. And Rapunzel manages to get through for a scoring pass. About a third of a lap between them as Sly comes in for a scoring pass. Can she get the points and call it? No, she's not. No, she's pushed through to the outside. Undertaken by Rapunzel, who is then knocked off to the inside by Missy Pow Pow. So Sly sails through for a score of 4, while Rapunzel is still trying to get through this pack. That's one lap now with no success, but some offense provided there by number 10, I think it was, sorry about this. Rapunzel hits the deck. Sly sails through, another pass, another couple of misses there do not halt her progress. That's a grand slam of 5 for Sly, as Rapunzel is once again recycled. D-Rama Bomb and Missy Popo, but not in that order, provide shoulder checks to get in her way. She's taken the star off, looking for a star pass. Missy Popo tries to knock her off, unsuccessfully so. She tries to find her feet. She's going to have to put that star on, as she's playing past her, tripping the velvet. She cannot score points without wearing it. Sly calls off the jam before she can score any points. So there we have on that final pass. That was 0 points to Leeds. And I'm waiting for the ref, but I think that was also 0 points for Sly for Newcastle. So now we have number 6, Killer Roo, serving a penalty in the box. So we've got a 4-3 advantage to Newcastle. And we've got Penny Bazaar jamming against Nina. And we're away. A little bit of a shoulder check from Penny to Nina there. She pushes through to the inside, but she's knocked off track by Sally Jones there, and recycled all the way back by Feral Fairy. Meanwhile, Nina is struggling against the 3-wall, but some offense is provided by Feral Fairy. But as she left the 3-wall, the 4-wall at the front, left a gap for Penny Bazaar to get through. So she gets through for lead. She's through on a scoring pass. She's now about to overtake Nina, but she was knocked off track by Sally Jones. Straight back into the thick of it though, and it's a dense pack, but Penny sails through on the outside. Killer Roo is now out of the box, and I think Penny is holding a WFTDA, a WFTDA certification stitch on pass patch, which evidently has come off somehow, but she is holding because they're very valuable. But Penny through on the outside. No last line of defence is Feral Fairy, but a shoulder check impedes her. She's knocked off to the outside and recycled by Feral Fairy, with Sally Jones forcing her to call off the jam. Well, that's a grand slam of 5 for Newcastle and 0 for Leeds. So extending the lead now for Newcastle. That's with just over 10 minutes remaining. We've got 178 for Newcastle. Plays 107. For Leeds. And looks like this time we're 2 down for Newcastle, so a 4-2 pack advantage to Leeds. We've got Big Tall Jock jamming for Newcastle up against, I think that's Tripping the Velvet, yes it is. A hit from Missy Popo definitely connected, but did not knock Tripping the Velvet off track. So straight away, Leeds have lead. A star pass from Big Tall Jock to Missy Popo. And Immodesty Grace, I think that was, came down, took Missy Popo with her. And Missy Popo now wearing the stars, through for a scoring pass. Leeds are forced to call off the jam. That's 4 to Leeds and 0 to Newcastle. So closing that gap ever so slightly. 67 point difference now. And we still have Buxley's number 52 for Newcastle in the bin. So that's 4-3 advantage to Leeds now, and we've got Rapunzel jamming against Guinevere of Jamalot. Guinevere moves towards the inside and we're underway. She goes against the shoulder of Nina and through on the inside. Belinda, providing a little bit of room, and that's all she needs to squeeze through for lead jammer. But Rapunzel, a hop on the inside of Anita Benasti, and she's through for a scoring pass. A good half lap separates them, so can Guinevere score some points before Rapunzel is in a position to do so? She comes through hot, but takes a little stagger on the outside, up against the back of Jen and Sonic. Another star pass is attempted. She whips the star up ahead and reaches forward for Feral Fairy, who receives the star and now must break through the front wall of Newcastle, while Guinevere is up against a similar wall at the back. It's 4-wall of Leeds. She's trying to push through, but Feral Fairy is through that wall. It's putting the star on. Can Guinevere score some points before Feral Fairy is in a position to score any herself? Possibly. Yes, she can. That's 3 points to Newcastle and 0 points to Leeds, I imagine. Although the jam ref is coming in to clarify. 3 points to in that last pass at least. 3 points to Newcastle and 0 to Leeds. So there we go, 185 to Newcastle, 113 to Leeds. And everyone is out of the box. And we have an official review. Official timeout. Referee's just going for some clarification there. It could possibly be to do with the number of points awarded to Leeds and when. Because there was some discussion, certainly, or at least some decision that the Leeds jam ref had to make, that he actually changed his mind from 0 to 2. Whether or not this was for the last pass, I am not sure. We're getting clarification just now. So yeah, we have an extra point being awarded to Leeds. So that should go up to 114, I imagine. Oh! I beg your pardon, that was the wrong way around. Yeah, that was Newcastle got the extra point, so it's 186. Newcastle to 113 to Leeds. Sly now jamming for Newcastle, pushing against that four wall of Leeds, and at the back there we've got Sally Jones. She's regained all her energy, she's sprinting from the inside to the outside, but the four wall of Newcastle just ahead of her, but no, she managed to get through the outside just after turn two. Leeds, Sally Jones is through for Leeds, closely followed by Sly for Newcastle. And as the Leeds blockers have a one blocker advantage, they do manage to get knock the jammer off track to recycle there. So that's during that pass, that was 2 points to Leeds and 1 point to Newcastle. I'm sorry, I got really excited there. I didn't know what I was saying. I hope that hasn't happened too often. But sometimes it's just how things happen, and then it's all good and it's over. So I will compose myself and we will begin again. We're just over 6.5 minutes in this whole bout, in this British Championships roller derby game. Remaining, we have a, 72 point differential between the teams. Leeds are going to have to work hard to close that gap, but it's certainly not impossible. Can you get 80 points in 6.5 minutes? Well, I can't, but it's possible, like I said. So it looks like we're going to have a 4-on-3 advantage start to Leeds. I think we're going to start with Penny jamming for Newcastle and Nina for Leeds. So this is a team timeout for Leeds, only 10 seconds or so remaining. We've got a, looks like a pivot line start for Leeds. So Newcastle need to keep the pack distance. No, it's going back. Coming back to the pivot line again. So we've got an almost pivot line start. We've got a half pivot line, three quarters, let's say. Three quarters pivot line start. Does that exist? No idea. Nina up against the three wall of Newcastle, and Penny up against the four wall. And a multiplayer block is called on. Is that Carnage? Multiplayer block is called there on young Carnage. And almost neck and neck now, the jammers, as the both blockers try to reform the walls. But Nina is through for lead, very closely followed by Penny. So Leeds have lead. Leeds trying to intercept Gin and Sonic, one of the Newcastle blockers. But now a wall of blacks separates. Oh, and the shoulder of Gin knocks Nina off and down. That was a big hit. No points to either side, but a big clout there from the shoulder of Gin and Sonic. So they have no change in the scores there, as 0-0. Just over 5.5 minutes remaining, and we've got a swap this time, 4-on-3 advantage. Pack size to Newcastle, and we've got, I think, this Spangle jamming for Newcastle. I think this might be the first jam of the game for her. She jumps around the outside and she's pumping those feet. She's pushing for all she's worth, but she's knocked off, but she's back on track before she can be recycled. tripping the Velvets, pushing her to the inside, but she goes down. Spangle takes advantage. She's 3 on the outside. She's through for lead. Spangle has lead for Newcastle, while Rapunzel is still trying to get past the wall of Newcastle. And Missy Piper, I think that was, forced the cut on Rapunzel. So it's a power jam to Spangle. Although, have I missed something? There seems to have been, I obviously evidently missed a penalty call on Spangle there, but the call then called on Rapunzel meant she's now out of the box, so I apologise for missing that, my eyes were in the wrong place. And Rapunzel now takes back the track as Spangled is trying to stretch the pack out. The last line of defence was Riggs. Spangled is through, but this is her scoring pass, as the first pass evidently did not count because she committed a penalty. So we do not have a lead jammer, and we will not have a lead jammer. Rapunzel is now up against the four wall of Newcastle, and a little knock to the inside there from hit one, pearl one, and elbows penalty is called on hit one, pearl one. So Newcastle down to 3 blockers, but as the star pass has been successfully passed to Tripping the Velvet, Newcastle managed to recycle the new jammer, as there has also been a star pass for Newcastle, as now Missy Pow is the designated point scorer for Newcastle, as she tries to nip around the inside, but she's pushed off. She's recycled back behind the old jammer, which is Rapunzel, as Tripping the Velvet comes in for a pass. The last two are, yes, a beautiful use your teammate as a projectile tactic, works every time, as Ellie Mental knocks D-Rama Bomb into Tripping the Velvet to knock her off. And I think a skate out of bounds penalty was called in the last few seconds there on, I think that probably was Ellie Mental. But 3 points apiece there for each team. And that gives us a difference of 872 points, as Newcastle have 190 and Leeds have 118. We have a 4-2 advantage to Leeds, as Newcastle have 2 in the bin, and we've got Guinevere jamming for Newcastle up against Sally Jones for Leeds. There is only 2¾ minutes remaining in this entire game, and Sally Jones finds a burst of speed, pushes past the Nitty Be Nasty, and she's through for lead for Leeds. Meanwhile, Guinevere is having trouble getting through the line of blockers there. A star pass is, what's happened there? Has that been successful? A possible low block call there on, is that, I can't see, I think that's Carnage, maybe a low block there, but Sally Jones is through for a pass of 5, and the star pass has been successfully, passed to Genesonic. So Genesonic now on a scoring pass, as Riggs is sent to the bin for what may have been an out of play block. Sally Jones is trying to get through for some more points now, as Genesonic comes through for a scoring pass. She hit checks Feral Fairy out the way, reforms from the outside, knocking her off to the outside. Genesonic's regrouping, trying again, pushing through the outside, inside. Did she get any points? No, she didn't. 4 points to Leeds, 0 to Newcastle. So there we go, with less than, we're just over a minute and a half remaining. Leeds are closing the gap, but it might be too little too late, I'm afraid. There's 190 still in Newcastle and 127 to Leeds Roller Girls. Can they get 64 points in the next minute and a half? With Nina jamming, it just might be possible. Nina for Leeds is up against Penny Bizarre for Newcastle, but Leeds have only got one blocker on track. That's a significant advantage, and Penny Bizarre passed in Modesty Grays without too much significant trouble. The shoulder of Missy Pow knocking Nina off to the inside, recycled by Spangled. And yes, an elbows penalty for Missy Pow Pow, sent to the bin, closely followed by Nina for what I think may have been a back block perhaps, but then also closely followed by Penny Bizarre for a cutting, a cutting penalty. So as she sits down, Nina will be released, and Penny will serve a handful of seconds. And she is, Nina's back on track now. The Leeds blockers chasing down the pack, speed it up, then they slow it down, trying to break up the wall of Newcastle blockers. D-Rama Bomb, oh, a little hip check, knocks Nina off balance just enough to knock her over, giving the Newcastle blockers time to reform in front of her, making her life slightly miserable. for this duration of the jam. Nina picks up another cutting penalty. It's closely followed by Penny Bazaar. A penalty, I missed what it was. This is a festival of penalties. In quite possibly the last jam. Almost definitely the last jam. Nina is then released from the penalty box, followed by Penny Bazaar. Last ditch burst of energy from Nina. She pushes through on the outside, but Spangle gets in her way. Then Durama Bomb gets in her way. The stretch in the back out. Durama Bomb takes a tumble. Spangle goes for a hit, but oh, she spins around. However, she spins around into the back of Penny Bazaar. Spangle then reforms in front of her. And Nina is knocked to the outside. Black 790, that Spangle is sent to the bin for a forearms penalty, but Nina is recycled by Elemental. Meanwhile, Penny Bazaar manages to get past the wall of red, and she is through for a pass of 5 points as a Grand Slam pass. What a way to end! What a way to end with 1,800 penalties between the two jammers in the last dying seconds of the last jam of this amazing bout. The unofficial, as yet final score stands at 195. To Newcastle to Leeds 127. So they Leeds really did step it up in the last few jams there, but it wasn't enough. It wasn't in time. But I think we can all agree that that was a frantic and hard game. Each team supplying excellent defence with excellent offence, topped off by some amazing jamming. Well, that's me shattered now. Yes, I'm vibrating slightly with the excitement of it all. I hope you've enjoyed this as much as I have. But that's the end of it. As soon as the refs have qualified the scores, the final score will be announced as final. But it's something of a formality, but obviously it's a formality that we must address, as there is a huddle going on for the referees. But looking at them, it is in fact... just congratulations. Yes, well done. You refereed very well. You're my favourite ref. Oh, thank you very much. That's exactly what they're saying. You can tell. So yeah, once they've finished in this huddle, they will check the score tracker's maths, and if it all adds up, the final scores will be finalised. That doesn't seem to be happening anytime soon, as the refs are not moving. As you can see, the crowd line the track for the obligatory hand slaps. So you get to touch a sweaty skater. Everybody loves touching a sweaty skater. Why wouldn't you? It's a good thing to do, isn't it? It's nothing like second-hand cooling sweat being wiped onto you from somebody who's just performed an extremely tough role in one of the hardest sports out there. So yeah, that was an awesome game, with Newcastle clinching the victory. And don't forget though that Leeds were skating short. They were only 11 players, so that's a tiring team that will tire more quickly as players get more track time, use the reserves of energy more quickly. But given the level that we're playing at there, neither team need hold their heads in shame. Both teams perform absolutely admirably. But Newcastle have clinched the victory. However, I think the refs have just finished with the huddle and they were about to come and check the scores, but the sweaty hand slaps have commenced, so they can't do that because they can't cut in front of the players. But here we go. Looks like the jam refs are now going to check the scores, and as soon as they are finalised, we'll let you know so we can absolutely guarantee which team has won and by how much. And once this is confirmed, we will have to go, because this is costing us money. But yeah, hopefully, like I said before, we will be streaming as many of these games as we can. And, you know, pass the word around. It's very expensive to stream when you get an external company to do it, so it's better for us to gather the equipment and the materials that we need and the help that we need to be able to achieve this ourselves. Yes, the scores have now been finalised, and the absolutely official final scores are Newcastle on 195 and Leeds on 127. That is final. It has been approved. I've been Badham. Thank you very much. Goodbye.